Sorry. Five, four, three, two, one. I wasn't in sync because I have the delay. God damn it. What a good idea. Hey, we're live. Hi, right. Guys.
It's Kanzuri in New Jersey. Holy crap. What's up? We're supposed to have a B-stream right now. But
yeah, we're currently
I don't know,
on a manhunt for our second streamer.
Both of our second streamers, in fact. Let me see. I don't even know if he's... We'll figure it out, I guess.
Yeah, if you have any information about where our second streamer could be, then please contact the local police department. We want him dead or alive. There's a bounty of $1,000.
Doesn't help if he's dead. You can't stream if he's dead.
I just
throwing that out there.
We can take his PC if he's dead.
Well, that would be not very nice.
Just kidding. I love you, Zelda. I know you're not dead, probably. You never know. The universe is random.
Yeah, our other streamer said he was here and just isn't. So I don't know.
Probably lost in Ohio. Actually, Zelda is from Kansuri.
Yeah.
The amalgam of states. I think he's from... Kansas, I think.
Oh, okay. So, like, I never actually knew which one he was from. Alright, well, we're getting going here for Kansuri, New Jersey. And they're quick about things. Let's see here. Kansuri first band, Hidden 2. That was fast. Nobody likes this Hidden 2, Dot. It's your fault.
Good. So, there's a little bit of an interesting fact about this is that New Jersey, they have they're lacking one or two players, I think, because, well, they're not lacking one or two players, they're not missing one or two players, they're just like, they're in the Netherlands right now, so they're in scuffed setups. They might not play maps that they wanna like actually play. They might play worse.
Yeah, Miles is like also not. I don't know who's here. I don't know who these teams are going to have available. Miles is asleep. Huh.
I'm not surprised. It is
3 a.m.
or 2. Or
I think it's
2 a.m. and it's currently 1 ETC, right? 1 ETC. So if the Netherlands is plus 1, then it's 2 a.m.
Well, I should probably. Oops. Okay, this may or may not have sound for you, Mr. Dada.
Did you update Windows?
No. But I figured out a method. And I tested it with Shadoose, and I think it works.
Holy smokes, it worked. I can't read the chat, but it worked.
I can make it bigger. I don't know. Okay. This should be better.
It's good.
Okay, now we just have to hope that. Oops. It doesn't lag everything to hell. Okay. It's a double time two first pick.
Not surprising. I mean, Kanzuri does have Fang, Zi, and Flareo. Two very, known speed players. Even though this is like, it's as much of a speed map as like I am a horse. Like I'm a mammal. I'm in the ballpark.
I think this New Jersey team is like unironically decent at speed, right? Like Cyrodiil and SXL is like not bad at speed, especially for an early round like this. Although Cyrodiil at 92% maybe is disproving my theory. We'll find out.
It's a little bit of start accuracy stuff. Like, people get lower accuracy at the start, getting used to the map.
I feel like this map, you kind of just shouldn't struggle on it if you're in on this type of map this early, you know what I mean? Oh, Flareo with a little oopsie. That wasn't good. That's not what you want to do. And then SXL throws it right back over, so we're just seeing a couple of early misaims.
You were saying.
We're just seeing early misaims. It just happens.
You can never be 100% on any map, regardless.
Fangzi begs to differ.
Oh, I don't mean mind. Accuracy.
he hit 100 anyway, it's fine. All right, well, we still have quite a few FCs going on. It's ACK lead because nobody on New Jersey is over 99, and all three of Kanzuri are over 99. That's really all that's going on here.
And with Dying Breaking, it's very...
Oh, yeah.
It's pretty much set for New Jersey.
Yeah.
Not New Jersey, for Kanzuri.
Yeah, like... Somebody has to break pretty much ASAP for Kanzuri if New Jersey wants to have any sort of chance on this. Wow, they didn't even drop any hundreds on the little longer stream there. Those guys are pretty good. Somebody asking, when are they going to merge the Californias? Maybe when they stop both getting like top six every year or top four every year. Okay, that's a break from insert. Wait a minute. We got a map on our hands now.
I think it's
Siru broke. Yeah, Siru broke as well. I mean, there's still like 300k score left for some reason. Or did SXL break? SXL broke. Never mind. I'm stupid.
Yeah, you need to look broke, at
like, yeah. I had to look at the combo because I was like, wait a minute. That's more score than it looks like it should be. We almost had a map there if... there was like a second player with a 900k plus for New Jersey, but there just wasn't. And that's a very quality FC from Fangzi, 1.2 mil. He went over 1.2 mil without SSing. We love spinners.
Spinners are good. We love spinners.
So 1-0 Kanzuri on their own first pick. I don't think anybody is going to be all too surprised by that. Also, I think I forgot to change my scene. Oh, no, I didn't, but it's just... my voice thing just is not in a... There's not a good place to put voice if there's two commentators. Because it doesn't fit. Whatever, this will be fine. Alright,
fine.
So New Jersey first pick of their own. After their opponent's first pick, Speedy Map. What do you first pick if you're in New Jersey? Is it time for some hidden abuse with known hidden player Dionysu?
You know what I'm gonna say. Like, you know what I'm gonna say.
Please, no. This is a match where that might not happen. I'm praying.
Are you sure about that?
Are you sure about that?
Yeah. Number 5 is...
Hey, it's actually hidden! It wasn't hidden. Oh, I didn't think you meant Nomad 5. I didn't think you meant Nomad 5, if that makes it clear as to what I thought you meant.
Oh, okay, I thought... So you thought I meant pretty much you.
Yeah.
No. That I always mean Nomad 5.
Oh. NM5 is, like... I don't know if it's feasible in this match. I don't know if either of these teams, like...
I think New Jersey wants to play Nomad 5. Just regardless. Because New Jersey has, theoretically, like, the more gimmicky sort of players. And they want to cheese out Kanzuri, which is more mechanically gifted. Especially if New Jersey doesn't have Miles.
Who does New Jersey put in for this? Without Miles, by the way, isn't he like kind of hidden fill for that team normally?
I have no idea. Sexel and Water are stepping in.
Is Sexel, Water, Yoshi? It's Fangsy, Flero, and one insert, which is just insert, but.
Yeah, this one guy.
Yeah, I know. A man after my own heart, right?
Absolutely.
And in we go. Miles and his brilliant idea of scheduling to 3 a.m. local time for where he was going to be.
And then sleeping through the match.
I have to think he would have been in for this, right?
Yes.
Like, there's no way, yeah. Well, we'll see how it goes. This being so early stage, it's not like you can't replace people for most, like, sort of normal picks. Obviously suboptimal, but not the end of the world. Oh, Yoshi? Okay. His cursor looks a little shaky. I don't know if he's got some nerves going on or what, or if that's just how he normally is. I don't know the last time I watched him play.
Yeah, same. I'm not particularly sure myself, but I don't think he's normally a mechanics kind of guy. And this is a more mechanics-based hit.
To be honest, he's always been like a five-digit player, so I've really not seen anything that I would know his skill set from. Until, like,
I know he's a reading. I know he's a reading kind of guy. Okay.
I guess that makes sense. SXL with another break for Team New Jersey. So they're down to just Water on the FC against Fangsy, Flaro, double FCing, and Insert is like 20 combo behind. Oh, I'm getting pinged again. Oh, it's bracket K. Don't care. I was hoping
something
that
about
was one
you
of
you saying it's bracket K. Don't care.
Oh, I didn't mean that in a rude way. It's just like not crude. It's not like split second important information. Sorry, I realized how that came off. I just mean like it's not important to what's going on right at this split second in time. Oh god, that came out so bad. I was hoping that it was like one of my streamers pinging me. I was kind of really hoping that was what it was. Where are they? Why do people just disappear? Alright, is this winnable if Fangsy and Flero both miss? Is there a world where this can come back? I don't think
yes.
so.
It can, but like...
Yeah, SXL just broke.
Yeah, no, not anymore, I think. Not with a 6,000 lead.
Yeah, this is Dunzo.
600,000.
Yeah, 6,000 would be really close. Yeah, that's like one note, man. Not, oh, there goes insert again. But it's a double FC looking like here, unless somebody breaks into the nothing ending.
Yeah.
Fang and Flero. Nice little double FC. 2.7 mil is, I think, a pretty respectable team score for this map. That's not bad at all. SXL with a tragic... I think that's like a 2x slider break, maybe.
Yeah, that's a double slider break, yeah. Based on the 50s.
Yoshi with one miss and I think a slider break as well. Water was just... It sort of felt like just kind of there because his accuracy was pretty far behind the other players, unfortunately. He was like 2% act down on everyone except for insert. Which is... not the luckiest. That's an early break point as well for Kenzuri. A quick 2-0. Plenty of time left. But
their pick again, right?
Yeah.
Kenzuri's pick?
Yeah. And they just go... Maybe Fremont 3?
Maybe Fremont 3, maybe, like... Not much here, maybe.
I don't know. Like, I feel like when you I feel like when you're discussing like the mechanics picks in this pool, Nomad 2 is like a really different. Yeah, there's the DT1. So they are gonna stick with like kind of more mechanics favored, but this is more staying with like kind of tapping type of stuff. Also, it's the best song in the pool.
That's quite an achievement considering it's sped up to 1.5 times.
Well, speed. I mean, the bass song is really good. Okay, somehow or other, Connecticut versus Georgia still hasn't started. I was going to give people an update on the scores. I'm not sure what's going on there.
Probably warm-ups.
Yeah, that's they must still be in warm-ups. North Cal is already up 3-0 on Indiana. To the surprise of no one. I think K is not doing warm-ups in any of her matches, which is totally fine by me, as you know. So like anything that she's reffing is always going to be ahead compared to the other matches at the same time. Which is why the Connecticut-Georgia match is a little behind the other two, because that's being reffed by someone else.
I mean, Exarch, if she's not following the forum post, you can just point out, hey, we want warm-ups, they're in the rules, and, you know, it'll happen. It's not like... Also, warm-ups are optional, so teams can opt to just skip it.
Also, warm-ups just suck.
No.
So swimming pools, Fangzi, Simply, and Flero, Dine, Siru, and SXL. So it's the normal rosters
normal,
here for this.
The normal roster for both. Yeah.
Well, it's Simply replacing insert for Kenzuri. They had insert in for DT2, and they replaced with Simply for DT1. But other than that, it's the other five are the same players as before.
Makes you wonder if. It's because of the AR. Even though it's like very much still close to AR10, which would be like 8.5 DT. It's like a little bit higher, and that might trip up people.
What AR is? Is it like 10.1?
10.1. It's on the screen right now.
Not on my screen, because I have to minimize the laser client or it lags. The particle effects are not the friend of also having gameplay going on at the same time. Unless you have a very good computer, which mine is like okay at this point. Early break from Simply, so in for, I believe, his first map of the three that have been played so far, and is going to become the first player to miss a couple times on this pick. Fangzi, Flero doing what they can, but it is still a triple FC for the New Jerseyans. They will take a little bit of an early lead here. No, but you wind up in this to be Kendrick. This is so funny to listen to at this speed. Oh, SXL? The alt patterns in this section can be really easy to miss on, as we see from Flero, Simply, and SXL all breaking.
Yep.
See if Dine and Siru can both break, make it through here. Ooh, it's Fangzi that breaks. All right, this is looking like a break point at this juncture. There's not much Kenzuri can do except pray. That's two FCs to no combo at all. This is interesting to see after the way the first couple of picks went. New Jersey getting what's going to be a pretty comfortable in all likelihood, break point here. Dine does find a late-ish break, but eh. Sirius still FCing, and SXL still has 350 combo, so...
Yeah, I think without any combos, any meaningful combos from Kenzuri, it should be over. Maybe a mispick here from Kenzuri, just based on this not being quite a conventional mechanic CT. Might have given the edge a little bit to New Jersey here.
Yeah, the like real difficulty of this, I feel like, is in those alt patterns in the second chorus, or in the second verse, I mean, I always do that, I don't know why. In the second verse, like, more so than in the actual tapping, like the faster parts.
They aren't really that hard, but they can catch you off guard, especially if you haven't practiced the map. And also, the buzz sliders on the DKI sections always trip up some people. But, yeah, solid FC from Siru here. And solid scores are all across the board, even simply with 500k.
Yeah, Siru, I think, kind of on New Jersey team for, like, mechanics in general, right? Like, that's, I think, kind of his role, so... Good to see him performing a little better on this pick after one missing. I guess that's fine too. He had the top score for the 1DT2 as well. Never mind. I love that the client does that. All right, well, breakpoint right back. New Jersey does still, of course, have to win their own pick here to tie it up, but they're a little closer to reaching that goal. Now it becomes really interesting to consider picks after. You lose a tapping map, get broken on a mechanics hidden, and then win a kind of tapping DT with some other stuff thrown into it. So where do you go? I mean, I think we're I'm going to check on this, but I feel like we might actually still have not... We might still be yet to see a Nomad 1 or a Nomad 3 pick in this tournament. Let me take a look. Wait, Nomad 1 has been banned 3 times and picked 0. Nomad 3 has been banned twice and picked 0. How is that even possible?
Because people don't want to play long maps, which is why the next pool will be only long maps. That way you're forced. Ooh.
Okay, DT3. I'm a fan. After you win DT1, I can get behind the DT3 pick. I think that makes sense.
I was told about a certain bus slider on this map today that I now realize might trip up some people after the sort of solo section in this map.
I saw that being discussed. What is, like, the problem with it?
The problem with the bus slider is that you're coming from, like, a full screen double section, and then the next note after the last double is 1-4 to the middle. Like, in a normal situation, if that was put in context, it wouldn't be that bad, but because it's a bus slider and you're used to going from half beats to half beats, and you have to go to 1-4 beat to snap to that bus slider without breaking, that means it's, like, super awkward, and people will default to going half beat, and they'll break on the bus slider because they're late.
All right, we'll have to keep an eye out for that and see if anybody seriously playing the previous pick. Yeah,
stuck in that drink.
Understandable, honestly. You get an entire swimming pool of liquor and just dive into it, like, you're gonna have a hard time doing much else for a while.
Yeah. Has anyone ever done that? Has anyone ever done the math to, like, how much that would cost with, like, the bottom shelf vodka?
Somebody go over to r/theydidthemath. See how dead you would be as well. What would your BAC be if you imbibed an entire swimming pool?
Yeah, no, if you drank it all, that's, like, more liquid than there's blood on your body.
Yeah,
your
by BAC far. Would be like, yeah, swimming pools are huge.
Your BAC would become an ABC. It's blood and alcohol.
Shit, some blood accidentally got into my alcohol stream. Wow, now what do I do? All right, well, Flare and Insert have a little bit of a hangover, I guess, from that previous pick. Fangsy's still on the grind, but a triple FC. Is Yoshi an old map player as well?
Yes.
He strikes me as like, does he have an OMF badge? I feel like he has an OMF badge.
He might have.
Somebody want to check on that? That'd be cool.
Yeah. We're coming up to the part. Right. Oh, both Fangsy and Yoshi Lover break.
That's neutral for the teams, really.
Yeah, but here we go.
Oh, it's that. Huh.
Only insert broke on it. But it is, like, deceptively hard. If you just look at the map, you think, oh.
Yoshi does not have an OMF badge? Huh, okay. Who am I thinking of? What five-digit, like, known five-digit player has an OMF badge? There's, like, somebody that's...
There's a couple.
Yeah. Alright, so... There is combo on Fangsy and Flareo, but Ciro is, once again, holding down the fort for Team New Jersey. And that is...
Very, very good play by Ciro, yeah.
Yeah, Ciro's doing well. Oh, maybe it was Giuseppe.
AKA
is.
Also, yeah, Ciro really hit it out of the park with that play. When I leave.
NM5. It's time.
Yo, wait. Kanzuri picked number 5. Okay, that's a surprise.
It's a Nomad 5 gambit. Is it really a surprise? Like,
it's
you
not
know,
a gambit.
It's a gamble.
Gamble.
Ah,
it's a gamble.
Yeah, but it's not spelled like gamble.
It's pronounced like gamble. What, you've been saying gamble this whole time?
No, but I mean, it's still a different word.
I think it's meant to be pronounced like gamble, therefore it's a gamble.
All right, everybody, also, get your reading glasses out.
Yeah, get your magnifying glasses. There's a built-in zoom function, magnifying glass on Windows, if you want to use that. If you're on Linux, I have no idea what the fucking, like, command prompt command is. Like, good luck.
Control up scroll. Control plus.
I wonder how pixelated the Twitch stream would be if you zoomed in.
I don't know.
See the circles at CS4.
I don't know that you could do it. I don't think you'd be able to fit it on your screen.
When those magnifying glass sucks, yes.
True.
It's true. Right, you've already looped the song once. That's how short it is.
Yeah, how long does this take, like, to get ready for? Come on, guys.
They're all getting out the the zooms. They're all making their resolution like 600 by 400 and zooming in extremely on external window settings to play CS10.
All right, here we go. Let's see. What will the highest accuracy be? Place your bets now.
88, which 88? Was what Lulzep got.
I think 88. That's a high bar, honestly. Oh, Yoshi! God, this is so silly to try to watch in tourney client, man. Oh my god.
On stream, if you have a quality below 360p somehow, you cannot see.
Probably true. I didn't even think about that. All right. Let's see. Insert with the break. Yoshi with the early break. Dying with the break. So it is simply and pro at being a noob. Pro at being a noob is definitively not being a noob currently. In fact, if he keeps this up, he might actually just 1v3. By virtue of having higher ACK than simply. Okay, well, not by much anymore. Up. Oh. All right, it's Kanzuri. The gamble is gonna pay off.
The gamble, gamble.
The gamble, gamble. I'd like to see win rate versus pick on this. Like, how often is it won by the team that picks it versus how often it's won by, like, as a breakpoint? 81? 81 okay. FC for pro at being a noob. 79 FC for simply.
Respectable. Respectable, respectable.
D-rank.
C-rank of C.
D ranks on SXL and Dine. C ranks on Yoshi Insert and Simply. A B rank honestly is quite impressive on that map. Like on like
a
on
B rank is good. An A rank is goated. An S rank is alien.
If you S rank this map, I don't think you're a normal person. I think you're fake. And
what if I told you that known hidden 5-digit SS player Zetera. No, not Zetra. Fucking Zalaria, sorry. They both start as a Z. Zalaria got an SS on this affinity.
That would be kind of nuts, to be honest. Also, in concurrent news, NorCal has defeated Indiana 5-0 in 27 minutes, which I think ties, or it might even beat, the two other 5-0s that we've had, the Virginia over Nevada 5-0 and the Ohio over Rhode Island 5-0.
The only reason why that might not be a record is that the old first matches were best of seven.
Well, I meant like this year.
Yeah.
Also, somehow or other, I don't know what's going on in Georgia versus Connecticut, but they're at 1-0. I don't know what's happening over there. I don't think I want to know.
Lag.
IRL lag. Alright.
This is where if I had a soundboard, I'd make like the modem noises from like dial up and stuff. Good one.
Best I can do.
A for effort.
Nah, ref wasn't waiting. I'm not really sure. Alright, well, we've
USC
got.
USC waits for no one.
Time waits for no man. Oh my god!
Yes! He turns the volume down. Like, this man is just not. He doesn't understand the spirit of the banger.
I've had to listen to this song like 15 times this weekend. You don't understand. You just don't understand, man.
The man max volume. You have your own volume settings. You can make that happen yourself.
Yeah, just turn it up on you and use the freaking FFZ audio compressor, and then you can make it even louder.
Every day before I go to the farm and work on the fields.
I just
to this song.
I thoroughly
it fertilizes my brain.
I just thoroughly feel like I'm being like it's like a like gaslit by the entire USC community because everyone but me claims to like this song, which just it can't be possible.
Aaron, you just weren't born on like weren't raised on the YouTube poop like music videos. If you understood the spirit of that, if you understood the spirit of those bangers, then you'd get it. This is like the
like,
Chinese version of
YouTube. Do all these people also think like Eight Sides of whatever the hell that stupid song, do they also think that song is good?
Eight Sides of Octagon or whatever?
Yeah, that thing. Yeah.
That's a cool. I wouldn't say it's like a super banger, but it slaps.
All right, I have been informed that at least one other person whose opinion I heretofore highly respect dislikes this song as well. All right, what do we have? We've got we have Hidden Hard Rock, No Mod, Hard Rock, Hidden. All right, I can respect it. Yoshi Lover, No Mod player. No easy. This might be the first time I've seen this map picked and not had a single player go easy.
Yeah. Technically, New Jersey has a slight mod advantage, even though they have one less player of a mod.
Is HDHR worth more than one HDHR person with
HDHR multiplies
two
the,
people with Hard
the
Rock?
HD multiplier?
Yeah,
as well,
huh? I didn't think about that.
Yeah, it depends if Sexo can actually FC the map. That's
yeah,
the kind of difference
yeah,
between Kenzuri and Jersey here.
If you run this mod combo, the HDHR player basically has to FC, assuming the other team like does well. That being said, they have double hit with double Hard Rock, which is like relatively difficult. Yoshi
oh, no,
Lover,
that is true.
Yoshi Lover and Water popping up. Okay, Insert and Flareo just both broke at the same time. GG, on to the next map we go. It's 3-3. Unless New Jersey literally just stops playing.
I mean, this is the hardest part of the map. So they can still, like, have a couple breaks.
This is just New Jersey casually gaming. Has this been three-wayed yet? Surely it has to have been. It's like 100% pick rate.
It might have.
Good job, New Jersey. Casual.
Yeah, good job.
Casual three-way. Yeah.
Also, I was mistaken because Kenzuri had double hard rock, which is a bigger mod multiplier on score V2.
That Akon water, by the way, 4-100s. Pretty solid. 4-100 for insert as well, but the 50, which may, I don't know if that was a slider breaker or a normal 50, and the two misses kind of hurt that a little bit.
If you're playing on hidden, this map is like, it's easy to miss, but it's easier to get a high act because it's OD7. So, like, take that as you will, but with hard rock, like, Fangzi had a good act as well. I think Sixo had, which I think he really quickly.
Hey, there's the FM3 from Kanzuri. Kind of expected this one. Tapping players, pick tapping map, more at 11.
I'm actually debating internally why they didn't pick this earlier. Like, you'd think?
Yeah, I expected them to pick this when they picked
DT1.
When they picked DT1, yeah, I thought this was going to be the pick there. I mean, it's like, quote-unquote, speed map. It's obviously not, like, super fast or anything. Like, it's... So it's not speed, it's just speed. Like, one of those is speed in lowercase, and the other is, like, speed in uppercase with italics.
So speedy the text is going to keep up.
Whoa. Okay. The whole computer just lagged, and I don't know why. Alright. Yeah, so we've got Fancy Simply Flareo. Dine Water. Is it Siru, you think, as the third?
Probably Siru.
Do you go like Siru, Hard Rock, Water, Hidden, Dine, Nomad?
I don't think it's Siru, Hard Rock.
Oh, it's SXL anyway.
It's 6-0, okay.
I'm assuming Water's.
Probably 6-0 Hidden. Oh, wait. Oh, it's probably 6-0 Hard Rock. Maybe HDHR.
Let's see who's actually the third.
Dine is probably Nomad.
Okay, it is Siru. Wow, that was a fast MP start. Holy crap.
I actually have no idea who mods what. On New Jersey, I think Sixel is going Hard Rock.
No, hidden.
No.
Dine Hard Rock. Ladies and gentlemen, Dine Hard Rock.
Okay, so they're betting on Siru seeing this. He is like their most mechanically skilled player by a decent margin. Meanwhile, on the side of Kenzuri, we have Fangzi hidden. And Flareo HDHR.
That's a
and
bold
they're
strategy.
They're running essentially the opposite strategy where they put their, like, obviously, no offense, but like their least consistent or least mechanically skilled player on the Nomad and try to have the high skill cap players kind of like carry with the mods and the mod multipliers.
Yeah. Simply did find an early break, but it's only about 70 combo behind, so it's not the end of the world. Mod advantage will carry them that far. Accuracy.
Showcase is tomorrow, Zev.
Oh, people are asking. Showcase, it's on the forum post. It's been the same for like 3 years. Why do people still ask these things?
Do you think people read?
I guess. Maybe they have memory, though. Maybe they have a brain.
Reading is so last century.
Reading is so 1900s. Dine and SXL are struggling on accuracy, which is really helping out Kenzuri here, considering they have a miss.
Flareo
is a little lower accuracy.
As long as they keep combo,
though,
they will pull away.
I don't know, will they? They're only 60 combo ahead, or 70 combo ahead, and there's a mod advantage for Kenzuri. This stays pretty close for the foreseeable future. Like, until somebody misses again.
I overestimated how much combo simply lost.
Yeah, really it was super early.
Yeah, it's still very, very close. Honestly, I think this will come down to the stream for the third PI. The kind of like sort of space stream. Yeah. A space that you can get on this map. That's the next kind of like break point.
Everybody looks pretty comfortable though. Even the players with a little lower ACK have recovered decently well. Dying the only one a little behind, and that's forgivable since he's on hard rock. Alright. Will we make it through? We make it through. Will we continue to make it through? Everybody holds through the next little stream. There are just no misses coming from anywhere, and Kanzuri, thanks to the mod advantage, is just keeping their nose out in front. This is going to be really closely contested into the ending, though. That score gap is only like 30k. Oh, it goes over! Wait, what happened? Is it just the score overall going up by the end, or was more ACK dropped, I guess?
Someone probably dropped a lot of ACK on the side of Kanzuri on that long stream.
This is so close. Wait, this is so close. It's just going to come down to hundreds at the end here unless somebody breaks. It goes to Kanzuri's side. Will it stay there in the last moments, though? Hold your ACK, lads. Don't drop a single hundred in this ending. Flareo drops one, but it shouldn't be the end of the world because Dine matches. And it looks like Kanzuri, the overmod by 15,000 points.
Oh, is it overmod?
Well, comparatively.
Without a three-way against a three-way.
Against a three-way. Yep.
That's the power of overmods.
Power of mod advantage. The extra hidden on Flareo made the difference. When the score is... He also had identical accuracy to Dine. Wow. It's like a slight accuracy lead for Kanzuri. Like, so minimal, though. It's what, like, I don't know, 800s or something. Just the difference between, like, Siru and SXL being at 98.6, 97.9, and then Simply and Fangzi being at 98.8 apiece. But that's very, very close.
So with that really, really close pick, Kanzuri gets into match point, but New Jersey has the pick and they have the opportunity here to send a tiebreaker.
So this is the
what
last
do you think
pick.
They will pick?
Well, it's not Nomad 1, it's not Nomad 2, it's not Nomad 3.
It might be Nomad 2. It might be Nomad 3. Honestly, if I'm New Jersey, I might pick one of those maps right now. But I think the more likely approach is that they're going with Free Mod 1 or Nomad 4. Because Fremont 1, they might have it's a little bit more of a like toss-up map where you can break on the 1-3, you can break on other stuff. And Nomad 4 is less mechanically intensive, so they might try to favor that.
Oh my gosh, they're going Nomad 2.
Ooh.
I did not expect this, but...
Honestly, that's kind of the same logic of Fremont 1, where the 1-3s are kind of like the deciding factor. Like, everyone can play the stream. Sometimes you can miss on one of them, but the 1-3s can really trip some people up.
I feel, personally, that, like, where I've seen misses on this are actually in the aim as well. Like, one of the streams, you'll just misaim slightly and it catches somebody out. Happened in whatever match it was last night, I think, that picked this. There was somebody had some misses in the streams at the end where the flow aim is pretty difficult.
Yeah, earlier today on the Illinois versus Texas match, I saw a couple people missing on the stream turns of this, which, to be fair, like, the streams are CS5, so they're a little bit harder to aim, and the turns happen quite frequently. Like, this is more of a flow aim stream map than a, like, conventional Nomachu, kind of like 200 BPM, you know, burn your fingers off kind of moment.
Also, just gonna throw this out there, but anybody who has nerves, low BPM flow aim is like at CS5.
Awful.
Low BPM CS5 flow aim, like GLHF.
I'm surprised a little bit at Yoshi Lover playing this. I wouldn't think he'd be in for this kind of map, but I suppose Dine is not really a low BPM player to begin with, and Sixel. I don't know, we saw Sixel playing the CS 6.5 earlier, so maybe
they didn't.
Maybe just not feeling confident on this.
Oh, I guess on the did he play Hard Rock on the Fremont too? Yeah.
Yes.
I was gonna say they didn't pick Hard Rock too, but I realized what you meant after. Flero, early missed. That's early enough that it shouldn't be too bad, but not good. For Kanzuri. And here we go into that aim. Insert and Fangzi both just instantly die. Yep. Yep. CS5.
Not looking good for
Awkward Kanzuri. Flow aim. And there's those one thirds. Everybody gets through for New Jersey. They don't have to hold all that much longer to take an insurmountable lead, considering we're already halfway through. There goes Fangzi. Are we seeing...
All of them went through the first hard section. If they just hold through this slow section over here, it should be pretty much guaranteed for New Jersey, and we're going to tiebreaker.
Annabelle and Waveform are singing. They're warming up their vocal cords as we speak.
Water might have other ideas. A little break in the slow section here.
It's got to be another break still for New Jersey, though, with a double FC still intact and only a quarter of the map left to go with a 400k lead. They have to have a really rough time in this ending, and Fangzi is just fully sending it, unfortunately, the wrong direction. There goes Yoshi. Oh, there goes Flero as well. All right, as long as Siru... Yeah, this is done, I'm pretty sure.
Yep,
There's not enough score left now.
Tiebreaker time.
Ladies and gentlemen.
One more round of 30, shoot tiebreaker.
After we had zero the last 2 years, we're getting at least two this year. That's kind of cool. That is kind of cool.
Do we ping it again? We're going to beat this time. Instead of first round of 32 TB since 2020.
Just another one? Just another
second
one?
Second round of 32 TB since 2020?
Just do that.
Thank you for the raid.
CLXXIII, which is a number, Roman numeral number. He is actually a really good clone hero charter. He makes charts of Osu songs in Clone Hero, and they're super, super fun.
173. Also, I didn't know that. That's
yeah.
cool.
Yeah. We spoke briefly a little while back talking about tournaments, and now he's got tournaments. So, hopefully all is going well. Yeah, super cool. Good song choice. A lot of Camellia stuff, and I think he was charting RPG. I don't know what became of that, though. Anyway, yeah, into the TB, its own phrases, and it is a gigabanger. 180 BPM, very standard, but that's where the standard ends because it's, you know, that Captain One style.
It's
RPG
a
is in the chorus now, let's go.
Yeah, it's a collab by Lavender and Captain One. It's a little bit awkward on the streams, but most of the map you can really just chalk it up as kind of conventional tiebreaker. Some aims, some streams, a little bit, I think, of 1-3 at one point.
I was today years old when I found out that that was a collab.
It's in the description.
I know it's in the description for, as of right now. I just found out. I clicked the link and I was like, holy shit, I never saw that in the description of this map. Oh, that's crazy. All right, so our rosters are going to be, kind of unsurprisingly, it's going to be Flero, Insert, and Fangzi against Siru, SXL and on Hidden, interestingly, so Prefmod, I guess, and Dine. We saw Oklahoma versus Oregon put up a few very good scores on this.
Yeah,
but again,
and we also saw Hidden there as well.
Yeah, it's true. Prefmod players be like. So hopefully again we'll get some big combo. I think there are places you can, this is like a good tiebreaker in the sense that there's places anywhere that you can kind of break and not in a bad way. It's just there's it's consistent difficulty through a lot of the pick. I think
the second half gets a little bit harder, solo especially. But
yeah. The second key eye and then really the solo and then the last key eye compared to the first third to half of the song. Definitely pick up
this. While this isn't a Nomad 1, obviously, this is the closest we'll get to a Nomad 1. And this is the closest we've gotten to a Nomad 1, in fact.
Yeah.
As we haven't seen it.
We've had two tiebreakers and zero Nomad 1 picks. Make sense of that. Oh, SXL just missed an entire stream. That's, dare I say that that's might have something to do with Hidden. But fortunately for New Jersey, Insert is going to trade the break right back.
better to miss this early on than potentially miss in the middle here. So let's hope players can hold.
My bold prediction is that, oh my gosh, Flero and Insert both with another break. Okay, they're not having a great time. My bold prediction was going to be that Fangzi and Siru both FC or at least come very close. I don't really think that's actually that bold because they're the two best players in this lobby, but it's kind of not something that often happens on tiebreakers.
To be fair, I would have expected Flare to be a little bit better than Fangzi on this map, because Fangzi, you know, he just struggled on Nomachu, and these streams are a little bit similar in the sense that they're a little bit twisty, a little bit turny, like, not super conventional. Not like, you know, the infinity sign, what have you, honestly.
Well, I think what changes, though, is that you go to, what is it, CS4? It's just CS4 and 180 BPM instead of CS5 at 170 whatever BPM. So, like, the comfort is going to go up because I think, for me at least, I mean, maybe, I don't know if everybody's like this, it's easier to aim streams at higher BPM than lower BPM, especially with, like, a normal circle size.
To a point.
Yeah, to but a point.
Yeah, I understand that.
Within your nominal comfort range, it's easier, like, on 180, 190 compared to 165, 170. Because it's, like, so awkward trying to move your cursor that slowly. Anyway, double FC still intact on Siru and on Dine. SXL with a solid built-up combo since his early break. Fangzi holding down the fort for Kanzuri with Insert building combo back up about 200 behind SXL. Flero doing what he can, but he is a distant third place combo on that team, and it's a 200k lead for New Jersey at the halfway mark. We get a little break, and they see the scores.
You're gonna see the other people's scores, yeah. Kanzuri needs probably two breaks, regardless. Oh!
Okay. Well.
Dying, just missing right after the break.
That's an unfortunate place to miss.
Really unfortunate. Now it's 1FC versus 1FC, with Sixo having a good amount of combo. So it's not yet going over to Kanzuri, but it could well start going over.
On a map this long, 200k takes a decent amount of time, but it will eventually happen if the combo stays the way it is now, I believe. The lucky thing for New Jersey is that they do have superior combo in their second best combo. SXL at 1200 versus Insert at, you know, 1000. It's just not by a huge margin. The accuracy is also in... Oh, there goes Fangzi! I think just ends it unless Siru breaks, like, right now.
They need a double
break. SXL broke. Okay, wait. If Siru breaks, this is still feasible, but it's going to be really difficult for Kanzuri.
And Siru needs to break right now.
And he did.
Oh.
And Dine broke as well, but there goes Insert. Kanzuri needed.
Flare is the only combo.
Kanzuri needed Insert to hold. Yeah.
I don't think it's enough.
No, it for sure isn't. It's only Flero, and there's just not enough score left. And there he goes as well. It's going to be New Jersey. They're going to take the tiebreaker now. It's all a formality at the ending. Just built up a big enough lead, and that when everyone kind of fell to pieces in the last quarter here, they were able to hold on. Misses kind of left, right, and center. Everybody having some trouble with this last key eye, where that difficulty does get a lot higher. But
I think people might have seen other people's scores at the break and, like, gotten super nervous because
possibly.
While the second half of this match is, like,
it's not this much harder.
Yeah, it's not, like, this much harder.
And that's gonna do it, though. New Jersey out to the early lead on the pick, and just managed to maintain it. A little bit of a come-from-behind win. I mean, they were down that quick 2-0 at the beginning of the match and then got the breakpoint back and played it very evenly the rest of the way out to send it to the tiebreak. And they clutch it out on the tiebreaker itself in not the most comfortable of fashion, but it was... They were always in the lead. They were always in the lead. That was...
That's the second upset we've had seed-wise, right? The first one was Iowa versus Colorado.
Iowa over Colorado, and also Oregon over Oklahoma was an upset as well.
That's our third upset.
So our third upset now. The first, they've all been pretty close seed matchups, I believe. This was, of course, 16 versus 17, which is the closest seed matchup you get in the round. Iowa versus, Iowa versus Colorado was 18 versus 15, and Oklahoma versus Oregon was 14 versus 19. So it's 14 versus 19, 15 versus 18, and 16 versus 17 were all won by the lower seeded team. That's actually kind of interesting that all three of those matches kind of in a row ended up being upsets.
Has the one immediately after, like seed-wise, been a normal match, or has it not happened yet?
So 14, who's our 14? 14 seed is Oklahoma. 13 seed was Pennsylvania. They beat Michigan pretty convincingly. And then that would be the next one up.
And then Georgia, Connecticut. Yes.
Georgia, Connecticut. Georgia, I think, swept. Yeah, Georgia won 5-0 in that one. So a pretty straightforward win. So it's just these middle three, or the bottom three, I guess, matches. All ended up being upsets. But that's well done, New Jersey. And I think Kansas, I mean, not a bad performance by them. I think they're a team that can go on to the loser's bracket and do okay. I'm going to update the schedule so we have all these scores put in, and then we can see what...
The way you said that, go on a loser's bracket, what do you mean? They just won!
Kansas?
No, New Jersey.
I meant Kansas, sorry.
Okay.
So we have NorCal 5-0, and we have Georgia 5-0. That's interesting, so three matches at the same time, two 5-0s and a 5-4. Like...
the duality of men.
Yeah. But yeah, I think Kansas is a team that can go to the loser's bracket. Let's see. So we'll get our matchups here, and we'll talk about that while we wait for the next match. Scroll up a ways. New Jersey
every
against...
Every one of the upset teams, right? Every one of the teams that were upset in loser's bracket can have a good one.
So, winner's bracket matchup, that gives New Jersey NorCal, GLHF, I guess, to them on that one. sorry, but that's going to be rough. Georgia goes on to face Carolina. That could be pretty close, actually. I think that should be a pretty good match. And then we scroll down some more. What's the other one here? Ooh. NorCal. Oh, that's right, because these two are next to each other. Yeah, so NorCal, New Jersey. And then we go to loser's bracket. Zoom on down. Kansas gets Indiana. That's super winnable for them. Connecticut
Indiana
gets
the lowest seed in the tournament, right?
Yeah.
No, not technically, yeah. Because there's a 33rd seed.
Yeah, I think they were 32.
Of the people,
yeah,
that made it. Yeah.
Yeah. So Kansas gets Indiana, which they should be able to beat. Maryland will be the opponent for Connecticut. I think Maryland is favored in that, but Maryland, I think, no, I feel Maryland's not quite as strong this year as they have been in the past, so we'll have to see.
Yeah,